You're full. You're breathy. It's just it's all the wonderful qualities of a fine podcast. Let's light this puppy.
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. The T-bone.
And chick brew.
Let's God bless all these years. Just get it right one time.
What do you want from me?
40 years they've been trying. You couldn't fire somebody if they were horrible, doing a terrible job for the veterans. And now you can say you're fired.
Okay. No one listens to radio.
And now for a quick disclaimer. The T-Bone
and Chick Brew
show is brought to you by nobody. We have no sponsors.
The show is still rated G.
For glorious.
It is a wonderful day to be alive. Hello, my friend. Hi, how are you?
Hola.
It is so good to see you. Another week full of people joining the Facebook page. I hope that translates into listeners. It doesn't really make sense that they would join the Facebook page and then not listen to the podcast. But those, but for those new listeners, thank you. It is exciting to always see that there's new people joining the Facebook group. With that, I guess I'll make a Facebook post saying, you know, it goes without saying, you should also be listening to the show.
Hopefully.
And as a reminder, for those of you who are new to us, of what we are all about, we're basically your own personalized morning show. It's an international morning show. Chick Brew there in southern Spain, me here in central Pennsylvania. We tell you about the things going on in our lives, and we do some spots, and we try to make you laugh, and we share our feelings with you, and it's usually a good time. We only ask for about an hour a week, and in return, we guarantee you one laugh an episode. Guaranteed. One. Now, you might get more, and we don't charge extra, but you get one per episode. I have a lot of customer service stories to talk with you about this week, but what's going on the coastal in coastal Spain?
Today has been a busy day. I went to a wine tasting class today.
Oh, a class on wine tasting.
Yeah, and food and wine, things that I love both of those things, food and wine. Super fun time. I loved it. Learned a little bit about like pairing wines with seafood. And then we also had like thunderstorms all day today. So of course, the one time this week that I had something that I had to be out of the house for, it finally rained all week. It's looked like it's going to rain. I've been like, oh, I want the rainy day so I could just justify sitting in my house working on these stupid papers for this class.
I understand the concept of a wine tasting. I do not understand the concept of a wine tasting class. So what are you actually being taught in this class that isn't about tasting?
So it was just talking about how you compare certain wines with certain foods outside of the red with steak, white with fish.
Doesn't that work? Isn't that perfect?
Yeah. There's just also more options. There's a plethora of options. So yeah. You just explored some of those. That's all there was to it.
Yeah, I'll give you this option. Anything you want with anything you want.
I'm a firm believer in that. It was a really good opportunity for me to try some wine that is not necessarily something I would buy.
You can look down on me all you want because I'm drinking white wine with steak. I don't care. You can be mad at me because I'm drinking red wine with my shrimp. I don't care. I care about whatever. And I learned a long time ago, there's something sneaky about wine. If you drink wine, this is a recommendation from T-Bone. I highly recommend you don't mix your flavors. Because you have the potential of creating a synergistic effect. And even though, you know, wine's about 5 to 8%, depending on where you get it, and alcohol by volume, when you start mixing your reds and your whites, you get that synergy, and it really kicks in a strange way. In the same way that although soju, it does not have a high alcohol content, it's so slippery smooth that you get totally bonkers on soju with, and it doesn't take a lot. It doesn't take a lot. I mean, I like the hardcore alcohol because that's easy. I understand my volume, my weight, my proof, my percentage. I got how much I could drink and still be normal. Soju was always a sneaky, sneaky beast. And combining wines is the same way. So if I happen to be at a tasting or a testing or a dinner or whatever it may be, and I'm drinking white wine, it doesn't matter what the next nine courses are, I'm staying with white wine.
You've made a decision.
Yeah, I've made a choice. And, you know, I do the same with beer and alcohol. Whenever I start to drink a thing, that's the thing I drink until I'm done drinking. If I choose a beer, I'm sticking with that beer the rest of the night. Because if you don't mix them, I don't get sick. And definitely with alcoholic beverages, you know, you're drinking this one and then you go and mix it with something else and then you got to remember rhymes and...
Beer before liquor, never sicker. Liquor before beer, you're in the clear.
I thought it was you're gonna... queer. I grew up with different people.
We were already one of those things.
Yeah, so, okay, so you did some wine tasting. That's nice. And you learned a little something that you kind of already knew. Boy, I hope you use those college credits. I can't help but notice you got a boo-boo. You want to tell me what happened there?
I cut some finger skin off.
While you were cooking?
I was making a dinner. Well, I was making, like, food prepping lunch for later this week. And my knife won over my finger.
It looks like an improvised bandage there. What have you got on there?
It's like right on the corner. It's not even like really that bad. It's just like just
on the cusp. Just
shaved, like, and there's no way to put a Band-Aid there. Like, there's just.
Several years ago, you may remember I was coming in to do the show, and I sliced one of my fingers, my middle finger, actually. It sliced my middle finger open pretty badly. And all I had available immediately was some paper towels and some red duct tape. So I had the giant middle finger with a red duct tape ball on top of it. I went into the ER there in Rota. Fantastic people that work at the emergency room there in Rota. They've seen me a couple of times. And they took care of me quickly, and I thanked them. And there was one of those celebrity moments as I was getting ready to leave. I was like, do I need to sign anything? Do you need me to do anything? They're like, no, T-Bone, you're good to go. Oh, thank you. Oh, so nice of you.
You know, I'll say something about this on the radio.
I don't know. No demand. Speaking of saying something about on the radio. All right, so we're going to be talking about James because he's definitely earning his superfan status this week. We're going to be, we've already talked about the seven new listeners that we have just this week, seven new people. And we've had 41 visits to the page from people who visit us but are not members of the group, okay? So let me just say this. Ladies, specifically ladies, mostly ladies, I'm not going to name you, but I want you to know I can see you.
Are you talking to our moms?
No, our moms are members of the group, thank goodness. But no, there's a lot of lovely people out there who participate in the Lunsby Facebook group, but are not members of the Lunsby Facebook group. I didn't realize until this today how much I've been kind of neglecting my personal Facebook page, where I've been doing everything towards the Lunsby page and forgot, oh yeah, I've got my own thing I need to do out there. So I haven't posted a workout video on my personal page in a long time. And then I also didn't even post last week's episode. So that's the benefit of being a member of the Lunsby page, which you can easily find by searching the hashtag LUNSB. If you're a member of that page, you get the most frequent updates of what's going on in my world, of what's going on in the Resolution Rewards program, what's going on in our cooking challenges and our questions of the week. It's all centered on the Facebook page. So for those 41 people who visited but aren't members, thank you for visiting. Now just join the page. And for those seven new people who joined the page, well, thank you very much. I'm not going to put you on blast. But in the last couple of weeks, our membership has grown substantially. Today, I am going to be talking specifically to anybody in my area about, we'll be talking about Rota in a second too. I went to get my feet done because, you know, I happy feet, which is probably the best place to get your feet done in the local area. Amazing ladies, amazing people. $40 that woman spent an hour and a half on my feet. She's so detail-oriented. At one point, I just wanted to say, I'm good. That's good enough. You don't have to. But she takes a lot of care and pride in her work. And she was in there with like tiny pieces of sandpaper, just getting the edges. She was fantastic. But my Happy Feet, my local pedicure place, is right next to the UPS store, which is my local return everything back to Amazon place, which is right next to Hampden Optical, which I've always meant to go into but never have because I've got several pairs of broken glasses. I'm a little rough on glasses. So I got several pair of broken glasses that I have tried to piece back together for one reason or another. It didn't work. So I knew one day soon I was going to do a trifecta. I was going to return something at UPS. I was going to go get my glasses looked at to see if they could fix them. And I was going to get my feet done. Well, Friday was that day. And I got to meet Carmen there at Hampden Optical. And she was so amazing. I've never had, first of all, when you walk into the place, it's like in a strip mall. But when you walk into the place, you don't think it's a strip mall. It looks swanky. It looks swanky. It's so well done. It really kind of knocks you out of sorts. You're like, wow, did I just walk in here? It's a beautiful place. Customer service was amazing. She fixed two pairs of glasses for me. Can't beat the price. Cannot beat the price because it would have cost me a lot to have those replaced. She is my go-to from now on for all things optical related. And if you're in the central Pennsylvania area and you find yourself out there on the Carlisle Pike, I highly recommend you go see Carmen at Hampden Optical because she was amazing. And then go to the UPS store and drop off some stuff. And then go to Happy Feet and get your feet did.
Could she repair, you know, the plastic that goes over the ear?
Uh-huh.
Rupert ate that off my favorite pair of sunglasses.
Uh-huh.
So did you know it's just a piece of sharp metal that goes in that plastic? So I can't really wear them anymore. Do you think that she could fix those?
I tell you what, if you send them to me, I'll make the trip. We'll find out together.
And now we're on an adventure.
I love it. That wasn't the only amazing customer service I received this week. Because yesterday, I found myself at my local Navy Federal. And my Navy Federal is not on a Navy base. I have to go to the freaking Army base to go to Navy Federal. I hate that. We have a Navy base. Why don't you put the Navy Federal on the Navy base? Make those losers come to us. But they don't. They make us losers go to them.
That's because they can't drive.
I walk in the door. I've never been treated so well at a Navy Federal.
Because it was on an Army base.
Our Navy Federal people there in Rota were mostly nice to me.
So we almost got fired the first time.
Yeah, well, I'll, you know what? I own that. I screwed up. And I made a mistake there, and that's the bygones be bygones. But for the most part, the people at the local Navy Federal in Rota were amazing as well. But you had to get up, and you had to stand in line, and you had to go to the counter, and you had to tell your business. Yesterday, old Caroline there, she greets me the moment I come in the door with a super friendly smile, invites, it was awkward, it was off-putting. She invites me to come over and have a seat next to her. You don't even know why I'm here. I'll take care of you, come on over. So I do, I'm lured over, and I sit down cautiously, knowing that I'm going to have to get up and go over and get money like you always do. No, I did not. 100% wrong. Seated there at her little and finely manicured table, she took care of my every single need. Everything. To include getting up, going, getting the money, and bringing it back.
I love that.
I felt like
a king.
Concierge. I felt like I had a banking concierge service, and I am regretful that I don't have more banking needs because I want to go and I want to experience I want to experience that more and more and more. That was amazing. If you have a chance to go to the Navy Federal at Carlisle Barracks and you see Caroline, tell her T-Bone sent you.
She's the one. She's the one. I love that. It's so rare that you have an experience like where it's funny because like, I feel like customer service is a craft, right? When I'm doing customer service oriented parts of my job, I want people to feel like they didn't have to do anything. It shouldn't feel like a chore. Like, you came in to see me about something. I'm going to get you what you need. It should be a positive experience. But now I feel like a lot of times, I feel like when I go certain places, I'm like, the person who was just here before me must have been the worst person on the face of the planet. Or the customer service representative that I'm dealing with is so afraid that I'm going to be a terrible guest that they're like, I just got to get through this. I just got to get through this. I just got to get through this.
So in my new job, I am very customer service oriented. This is what I do. I do customer service. And I try to do it with a smile. I try to make everybody happy. I try to give everybody what they need with little delay as quickly as possible. And I must be doing something right, because yesterday when I took Zeus out to the base for his off-leash exercises, there was a group of reservists that were in for the weekend because they're reservists, and they were running their PRT. And as one of them came by me, she's like, "Hello, Mr. Oh, hi." I didn't realize I had left that kind of an impression on you, but apparently I did.
I love that. That's good.
Yes, and this is what I do. It's, you know,
because if you had provided bad customer service, that reservist would have been like, I'm only here for a few days. I'm going to trip this old guy and keep running and be like, he tried to trip me.
Okay. Reservist think in a weird way, apparently.
Yeah, if I'm going to only be here for a weekend, I can trip this guy and then keep running. No one will ever know. No one will know it's me.
I wasn't running.
No, as a reservist, running, doing my PRT, I see the enemy. A little side swipe, keep running. No one will ever know.
Okay.
Because you're transient. They'll never see you again.
Until next month. So back to Rhoda. I don't know if you saw, but I've been back on the Rhoda community page. Because... We were very good at putting out a message in Rhoda. And the message was this: do not use your car as a safe. Do not leave anything of value in your car, not just in Europe. To our listeners in the United States, I say the same thing. If it's valuable, lock it up. If you think it's locked up in your car, you don't understand the concept of windows. They will break your windows. Oh, hey, hi, how are you? Yeah, we're going to do the thing. We're going to break from this. Hold on 1 second. I have to put her out of camera view because the microphones will start to give feedback if she's closer. So she is here. And we're going to play her intro music now.
And now, J-Bone reads from the book, Forgotten Jokes for Older Folks.
That is the opening for the new segment, the fan favorite segment. People have been commenting that they enjoy this so much. This is J-Bone, our producer, reading from a silly book. What's going on? The heck?
Thank you for being a friend.
Yes.
Travel down the road and back again.
Yes.
Confidant.
All right, ladies. Let's get it back on track here.
You're not our supervisor.
So what she does every week is she reads us a couple of two jokes picked at random from this silly little book called Forgotten Jokes for Older Folks. It's entertaining, and that's why we're doing it.
Hi, T-Bone. Hi, Chick Brew. It's J-Bone. And today I'll be reading you jokes on possessions and fashion. Money's getting tight for everyone. Last week, a robber handed a bank teller a note that said, "This is a stick-up." She handed him one back that said, "This is an IOU." Can you believe how short skirts are getting these days? In my time, something that short wasn't called a skirt. It was called a belt.
Read with emphasis, or emphysis, if you will, from J, with plenty of hyperbole emphysis. That's J-Bone reading forgotten folks and older jokes. Oh, thank you so much, as always.
Adios.
Adio.
Hasta luego.
Hasta luego, guapa.
Just comes in, does her part, and disappears.
Perfect.
Mm. I hate that you're leaving, but I love to see you walk away.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for being a friend.
So back to our crime venture real quickly before I lose that trend or thought process. For people in Rota and for people everywhere, don't leave your valuables in your vehicle. Your vehicle is not a place to protect your valuables. And especially in Spain, what you may think is not valuable has some kind of weird value to Spanish crooks. They will... Hey! You don't know. Last week... we're recording. We're having a good time. I've got the AC off, even though it's a little bit warm because I'm right next to the AC handler and it makes a lot of noise. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she turned it on. So, you know, I get over on my phone here and I turn it back off. And then like 5 seconds later, she turns it back. So it got quite frustrating. The battle back and forth between me turning it off
battle
and her.
Battle of the breeze.
Oh, my goodness. She thought there was something wrong with it. That's why it kept turning off until I started screaming.
Bless her heart. It just keeps shutting off. Oh, no.
I'm going to make this public apology to anyone who's ever offended by anything I say. The episode 1139, I believe it was, where we talk about the pasta being thrown away, I had made some attempts at humor by disparaging particular groups of people who may have made the spaghetti that needed to be thrown out that were not Italians. Oh. I may have hit a bone with someone that approached me afterwards, and I'm not going to put that person out there, but I'm just, I know, it was said, I believe lovingly, Damien Robinson from the DNR podcast. He caught me on Thursday night, and he was talking about, he had listened to the show, he enjoyed the show, and then he had mentioned that he was taken aback when I said something. I believe he was messing with me, but I'm not going to repeat it, but I'm not going to take it down either. If you want to listen to it, you can go back to T-Bone Gets Got, or T-Bone Got. That episode, I believe it was 1139, may have been 1140. I don't know. If, as always, if I offend you in any way, shape, or form, it is not intentional, and if you bring it to my attention, I will always apologize and beg your forgiveness if it's something I did wrong, but if I didn't do anything wrong, I'm going to try to explain myself. That's pretty much how that works. I haven't had to make a lot of sincere apologies. I've made a few over the years. I've offended some people and have upset some people.
I will say, if an apology is due, you have been pretty good about not only making the apology, but a genuine apology.
Yeah.
A lot of people, and people don't do that anymore. Like, people don't do a genuine apology. Like, oh yeah, sorry. I'm like, I don't feel like you meant that at all.
I generally don't apologize unless I mean it.
Unless you mean it.
Yeah. You got to say you're sorry. The blank I do. Yeah, I don't have to say anything. I don't have to do anything but be black and die. I've been saying that for years. Hey, everybody, it's T-Bone. Did you know you can listen to The Luns B Show on the iHeartRadio app? The team at iHeartRadio has created two new features on the app. You can now auto-download to your device and be notified when other new episodes are released, all for free using the iHeartRadio app. And you can listen to The Luns B Show from anywhere. iHeartRadio. Discover music, radio, and podcasts you'll love. While that's playing, I'm looking at my Mevo camera that's looking back at me that I wanted to use for a particular project I have coming up, but it's not the best camera for this particular task. So I have been searching high and low throughout the entire household looking for my DSLR, and this is how you know it's a great joke. I believe it was Bill Engvall. It could have been Jeff Foxworthy because they both have a similar voice. But one of them said something along the lines of, anytime you're looking for something, you always find it in the last place you look, right?
Right.
That joke has never evaded me. It's always stuck with me. And whenever I'm looking for something and I finally find it, I always look in one more place. Just
just so they're wrong.
Just so they're wrong. Just, it wasn't in the last place I looked. It was in the second to the last place I looked. I looked one more place.
You will not be right. I will be right.
I will do things that make me feel right. Hey, you ready to talk about food?
Yeah.
It's time to talk about cooking.
And tonight prove one thing. You know f*** all.
As a reminder, Chick Brew is she's a chef. She wears funny hats. She wears aprons. She cooks things. She chops off her finger. That's what she does. And every week she's usually doing something that's entertaining. I also cook. And when I cook, it's also entertaining and can also be bloody. So we talk about our food experiences. We encourage you to participate and talk about your food experiences. So this week, what's going on in the cooking world there, Chef Chick Brew?
Well, after 2 weeks of school and not being at work, I have to go back to work. So I spent this afternoon after my wine class. I then came home and I started doing, like, you know, some meal prep. Some veg.
So you go to the wine tasting, you come home, you do a meal prep, and have a knife accident.
Cut my whole finger off. It's so stupid. It is the, like, tiniest, it's just the corner. It's the smallest cut, and I could not get it to stop bleeding. I was trying to put my ribs on the grill. I was, you know, I was like trying to just finish these things, and I could not get it to stop bleeding. It's not deep. It's just...
No. I 100% understand. Ever since they put me on these blood thinners, you know, I got an ingrown hair in my mustache, and I pulled that out, and then I was bleeding for a week. It's great. All my food tastes like iron. It's pretty awesome. No. All right, so you're doing the meal prep. Tell us more about this meal prep.
I got some broccoli and some salad things, and then I did a rack of barbecue ribs in the Instant Pot, finished them on the grill with some barbecue sauce, and then I did some of the little Korean spare ribs with the orange juice and honey and let those marinate with some chili powder, finished those on the grill. Well, I cooked those on the grill. They don't need any time. So I got some vegetables, some salad, and some meat for work this week.
Sounds delightful. I try to do my meal prep, but then, you know, I'm not responsible enough to do my own meal prep, so the producer's got to jump in there, and she does the meals, because I get it, man. I get it. She loves me, and she wants to take care of me. I get it. But, you know, I am also quite capable of taking care of myself, and sometimes I just want to take care of myself. I don't want to be waited on hand and foot.
Who are you trying to prove this to? Me or yourself?
I know it's such a horrible problem to have, but you know, I am on the cuspis. It's second time I've used that word today, of 30 days in a row. We'll talk about that in a resolution reward.
Do you want me to punch you in the throat?
No. I'll talk about the exercise thing in a bit, but I want to talk about the food part now. So 30 days in a row, I'm doing great, but I really haven't lost a lot of weight since the initial weight loss. So
right.
I got to lose some weight. And I think I'm going to do that by starting to go back to doing shakes in the morning. I've got the little bullet blenders, and I've got an ice machine, and I've got powders. So I'm going to start doing that. And see if that, because she makes me salad every day for lunch at work. She makes me a salad. I take a yogurt with me. But, you know, I got to tell her about the salads. Hey, pull back on some of the calories that you're putting into these salads. Because although these salads are amazing, the whole point of eating the salad is not to consume 1,000 calories. A little pepperoni won't hurt you. Yeah, mama, I know. A little pepperoni won't hurt me. But every day, a little pepperoni, some cheese.
You have, like, what is probably the most delicious salad. It's probably, like, a full antipasta with a salad.
Oh, they're amazing. It's just, they're very high in calories. And the point of eating, if I wanted to, you know, I'd just go to Burger King and get me a double, triple something. I don't know. I haven't had anything from Burger King in God knows how long. But even when I go to fast food restaurants these days, for whatever reason, I haven't eaten.
Sometimes
you got to go. I get the basic. I am bravo, bravo, baby. I'm a I am fully BB on this. Basic, you know what I'm saying?
Bareback.
Whatever their burger is, I just get the burger. And it's a challenge, but I do it, and I only get one. And I can tell from the reaction of the drive-through staff that nobody else is doing this. Nobody is driving up to the window and saying, yes, one cheeseburger, please. And you could hear the awkward silence. And then they're like, do you want to make that a meal with a large question mark at the end? Like, no, just one regular cheeseburger, please. Would you like fries with that? No, just one cheeseburger. Okay, that'll be $7. Come
on. It comes out, it's like the size of a slider. You're like, what is this? What size are you?
Yeah, but if I go to a fast food restaurant, that's usually all I get. Just enough to hold me over.
Yeah, it's not the meal, it's the carryover.
Well, it's and the real calories in all of those burgers is not in the product itself. It's in the bread.
It's the bread.
Yeah, it's not even, it shouldn't even be classified as bread. There's so much sugar in it. It should be like cake. Like, here's a cake burger.
I do love cake.
When I was in the commissary, still talking about food, even though it's not food that I cooked, I didn't realize, while I was on the Army base, I went to the commissary to look around. I didn't realize the commissaries in the United States have fantastic deals on meat.
Yeah.
I was blown away. I saw one couple who had a shopping cart full of nothing but meat. And I started looking at the prices. I'm like, wow, it's almost worth the, you know, hour, 30 minutes there, 30 minutes back. It's almost worth the trip to go and buy meat. But I don't eat that much meat anymore. I did pick up some tuna fish. Yay, tuna. I got some tuna fish, and I got some, you know what they had? They had olives stuffed with garlic.
Oh.
And those are very hard to find in the States. So when you find them, buy them. Still living in Rota, when you go to the market and you buy a kilo of olives stuffed with garlic, enjoy that while you can. Enjoy those delicious little morsels of deliciousness.
I'll say tunas. Ooh, I'll say tunas.
So, again, for the new listeners, that's what we do. Usually I have some type of food thing that I share. She has some type of food thing that she shares. We do food things. We talk about food, but we're interested in your food too. If there's any food that you want to talk about, if there's any recipes that you're questioning or discovering, again, she's board certified. She's sanctimonious. She's an actual chef, and she can answer any chef questions that you pose on the Lunds V page.
I'm really just hungry.
Are you?
No, but generally, yes. No, I ate too much.
What did you eat?
I had a little bit of everything that I made for dinner.
Oh.
You know, you gotta test it. So I was like, I have some ribs. I have some more ribs. I have some salad. I have some broccoli. And the next thing you know, there's no meal prep. It's just in my belly.
I had a Jamaican beef patty. That's what I had.
No. Oh.
I love Jamaican beef patties.
I'm super sad because the girl that does the Jamaican food, she's about to PCS, and where am I going to get my Jamaican food fix?
Oh, I don't know, because there's no place in Rota that I would recommend for Jamaican food to include the guy who thought my wife was pregnant.
Oh.
Old Miguel.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, it was just horrible. It was horrible, the whole visit, and I gave them a bad review. And, of course, he's one of those people who's got to come back and say, I don't think so. Whatever. You know, I got 60,000 views on my reviews, and you've got one response. I'm okay. You can have your opinion about your place. We mentioned it briefly. Why don't we talk about the Resolution Rewards Program?
We'll be right back. It is time for a resolution rewards update.
Boy, that comes in great now that I fixed that audio. So, for those of you who don't understand what the Resolution Rewards program is it's a resolution, and it's a program that comes with rewards. And the rewards here are cash money. Every one of the participants put in some money, and at the end of it, one participant will get all of that money. If this competition goes longer than July 1st, that money will be doubled by me, because I am enjoying the competition itself, and I was a member of the competition, and I actually... I wanted to win the competition, and then, you know, I almost died. So that didn't work out for me as well as I was expecting.
Getting in the way.
Yeah, I went back and reviewed multiple times. I don't see... I'm sure she will correct me, just like you corrected me when I didn't see yours. And I looked through it again, and I'm trying to find it, but I'm missing a Chelsea. I'm missing some Chelsea videos. I think the last one I had on her was Friday.
I don't know what day we're on currently.
We are currently, well, you know, it's not Friday.
It's not Friday. I think tomorrow's Monday, right?
So yes.
We're on Sunday.
Yes. So I don't know. We'll find out. You know, it's better if it happens, it's better that they let us know that they're out of the competition than us having to figure out, because I don't want to wrongfully accuse somebody.
I got receipts.
And while...
I also don't want it to be, it can't come down to just me and Tommy. That's not fair.
It is fair. I am right now being entertained with something that has been posted on the group page. Mr. Taney, as always, message them asking to sponsor the show or give Tony a battery powered bidet if they ever make one. And he put a clip on there from the Bidet King. Super fan James is just doing a great job of being a participant in the show. He is currently down there in the Norfolk, North Carolina area, going through some training, getting motivated to do some awesome stuff. But yeah, I looked through back to the Resolution Rewards program. I haven't seen a video posted for Chelsea. I'm going to do, while we're here together, I'm just going to do a search on the page for everything she's posted. Just to make sure that, because it would just be down to you and Tommy by then, right?
Oh, God. That would just be, oh, that's a fancy bidet. Enlist today. Oh, pew, pew. Toilet paper punch. Kick. Bidet.
I see for the 19th. I don't see one for the 20th.
Wait, are we on the 20th?
Today's the 21st. In every time zone.
In every time zone.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll figure it out. It is possible that we could be down to our final two contestants, or we could still have three. But they compete every day. They post a video. If you're following the Lunsby page, you see that videos. Those videos show up every day, but they don't take up a lot of your time. It's just, 30 seconds of them saying, hey, you're getting in my workout in. You also see videos from me. Did you see my video?
I see one from one day ago. What day is this?
That was the one on the 19th.
Is that? It just says one day on mine.
Is she wearing a black shirt?
Black shirt with dangly rainbow earrings.
I didn't know. Yeah, I can see the rainbows now. And she's outside walking.
Go for a walk.
Yep. That's the 19th. That's not the 20th. Anyway, she'll.
Okay, well. Because I see one. It says one day. And then I see 2 days. And then I see 3 days, 4 days.
Right. Did you see mine where I was planking?
It's the worst, right?
Actually, so the first time I did a plank is the first time I've done a plank in a very long time. And I was destined, because I was on a 28 kick, I did a minimum of 28 minutes on the treadmill. I was going to do a minimum of 28 seconds on the plank because it was my 28th day in a row of exercising. And I was focused on the 28 seconds. And I did my video, and then I said, you know what? I think I could do better. So I got back up into the position, and I went a full 45. Now, I don't know, because the planking thing was never part of the physical agility testing or physical readiness test when I was on active duty. You, at your age, how long do you have to plank for to get a passing score?
I think it's like a minute, and then I try to get the 2 minute.
Okay.
Like, the problem with the plank is that it's just so boring.
Yeah, it's right, all mental. It's all mental. And while I'm doing that, I'm like, I could do this longer. I just don't want to.
I don't want to. Why?
Right?
Yeah, no, and that is literally the hardest part. Is like, so in my videos, I'll do the 30-second plank, whatever, and that is more or less just to remind myself that 30 seconds goes by like that. It goes by super fast, especially if I'm doing it in the video. By the time I have said hello,
there's 1 second.
Like we're flying through 30 seconds. So yeah, I just to and then people that do like, oh, what was the guy, the world record plank holder? Why? Who hurt you? Like, why are you doing this?
You really, it's not that much to me. It doesn't feel like it's that much of a challenge physically. I've never reached the stage of exhaustion yet, but I feel like I could probably pass a plank PRT right now.
Most definitely.
Yeah. I mean, I'm old, so therefore my time wouldn't be as long. And I did the full 45 seconds. And again, the only reason I quit is because I was bored. If I had something to entertain me, I could probably do it for a lot longer. But because I'm down on the ground, it's not like I can look up at Bumpy Johnson up there, because that additional head strain. Have you seen that? The Godfather of Harlem?
No.
Yes, I'm currently watching that right now. I'm enjoying it. There's a lot of heavy hitters in this show. Luis de Guzman and Forrest Whitaker and Paul Sorvino and Chaz Palminteri. I mean, there's a lot of big actors in this movie. It's very entertaining. It is Harlem crime scene prior to Frank Lucas. Frank Lucas was, that was my time zone. That was when.
And what is it called?
It's called The Godfather of Harlem.
Godfather of Harlem. Okay.
Yeah. It's available on Hulu.
I just watched the OC Mountain, which was just weird.
Is that a reality show of some kind?
Yeah. So it's like the OC family. This guy was the last person in America to stake claim to land in Alaska. So he hiked like 57 miles up this mountain and laid the last claim to land. And this program was put on by the BBC. So all the contestants are British. And they are fighting to basically get to win his property.
Interesting.
In Alaska. But it was weird because it was a bunch of Brits trying to win land in Alaska from a crazy old guy who lived in a mountain with one eye.
Alaska is a strange place because Alaska, The Last Frontier, a TV show that I thoroughly enjoy, that whole family is from like Sweden. And they came over during World War II and they staked a claim there. And, you know, a bunch of Swedish people in the middle of Alaska. You've done it, ladies and gentlemen. You've reached the educational portion of the program where every week we pull two facts out of the book of everything that you most likely had no idea about. We come across some amazing facts in the book of everything. If they are good, don't say it. Don't say it.
You can't see me.
Don't
know.
Say it.
No.
If the facts are good, it will stay with you forever. And she usually takes this opportunity to tell you one that I don't want to talk about every single time I remind people that there's a potential that one of these things will be an earworm in their brain hole. Okay? So, stop it. It is harder not being able to see you. Here we go. Our first fact from the book of everything is a little lesson in Spanish. In Español, the word esposas means both wife and handcuffs. I don't think that's an accident because my esposas definitely likes to put the esposas on me. That's a fun word. It's a fun word. Esposas means wives and handcuffs. And now for something that you'll really enjoy, a little bit more intelligentsia here. Uranium is 40 times more common than silver and 500 times more common than gold.
But where is it?
Yeah, and not only is it 500 times more common than gold and 40 times more common than silver, I bet you it's probably pricier. I haven't gone pricing uranium lately because I believe that's the quickest way to find yourself on a terrorist watch list.
Oh, so I shouldn't Google. I just picked up my phone.
Dear Google, what is the fastest way to get on the terror watch list?
It's not to Google. Like, where's the uranium?
I don't know. I don't know if they're trying to tell us that uranium is that abundant or that gold is that freaking rare. I watch the gold shows. I enjoy the gold shows, and I see what they have to go through to get a little bit of gold.
I do love a good gold show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you grow up with these people. You get to know them, and then they pass away. You feel sad because you've been watching the gold show ever since, yeah, for a long time.
The gold.
Yeah, they're evolving. I like the gold lady that does it on a boat there in the Bering Sea. She goes down in the water to get the gold. I don't remember what that one's called, but she looks like a friend of ours whose name is currently avoiding me. Pretty blonde hasher. Like, she's pretty, but in her photos, she's, like, beautiful. But in normal life, she's pretty, but in the photos, she's, like, beautiful. What was her name? I know what her hasher name is. But for the life of me, I can't remember her real name. Anyway, she looks similar to the fishing, the gold fishing woman. Yeah, they go out on the little barges, and they go down with scuba gear with a vacuum cleaner, and they're just sucking up the dirt.
The dredging.
Yes. Yes. I prefer gold fishing. That sounds better. Hey, in other news, not that we've got to the news yet. We'll get to the news next. In other news, another person has died from eyeball juice. In case you need a reminder, don't use eyeball juice anymore.
We're off the juice.
Yes.
Just in case anyone was wondering, any listeners were out there curious.
And if you're curious what we're talking about, just go back to the episode, eyeball juice. Now, let's do the news.
And now it is time for headlines from around the globe.
In our weekly news segment, Chick Brew gives me a headline from somewhere around the globe that I have never seen before. I will mine this headline for something of humor or fact-finding mission. We will have a conversation about whatever the headlines are that she provides. You got a headline for me?
I do. Dwarf bullfighting banned in Spain.
It should be 100% banned in Spain, all right? I have some friends that are dwarfs, and I would not want to see them in the arena with a bull. Unless, let's be very clear, unless they had miniature bulls. If there's a dwarf bull and then there's a dwarf matador, I can't tell you how much money I would pay to watch that. I would pay a lot of money.
Rupert in a bull costume.
I didn't know Spanish bullfighting, midget bullfighting, dwarf. People. Jeez. We call it midget wrestling still. Then they don't call it dwarf wrestling because it sounds wrong.
Is that still a thing?
Huh?
Is that still a thing?
Oh, definitely. That definitely is a thing. My favorite midget wrestling is when the midgets team up against a normie. Those are and is this the concept of the bullfighting that is now banned in Spain, where there are a bunch of midgets teaming against a normie bull?
I don't know. There wasn't. Well, I didn't read all the way into it.
It's just, I can't believe that it existed.
It was a short headline.
I appreciate it. I can't believe that it did exist, and I can't see a lot. I can tell you right now, I don't normally do this after a show, but after this show, you better believe I'm going on YouTube.
While you're doing that, can you look for the uranium? Thanks. Cool. I feel like those two searches together balance out, and they would be like, oh, this guy is not a terrorist.
Brad Williams is a little person out there doing comedy, and he's really he's getting a lot of notice. He's got a special out there and making people laugh. And he says watching a little person run is one of the joys of life. Because it's just hilarious. And if you get a bunch of little people running, it's very hilarious. So a little person in a matador costume going up against a full-size bull. Unfortunately, it is now banned in Spain, but I can tell you I will be a connoisseur by the next time we talk about this. Do you have another headline for me?
I do. World's most expensive ice cream costs $6,696 per serving.
$6,696. That's a very strange number. It's got the three sixes in there and four sixes, except one of them's upside down. Anyway, what kind of ingredients would go into an ice cream that costs, well, round it up, $7,000 a scoop?
Yeah, so it was a combination between Japanese and Italian. It was a co-mingling, and they didn't even go into the flavors. They just said...
There's no need... Yeah, there's no need, because you're just doing it for, you know, one person. You're doing it for a billionaire, you know.
The pricey treat ingredients included are a rare white truffle grown in Italy.
Ooh.
That costs about $6,905 per pound. And also includes Parmigiano Reggiano. I don't want to eat that.
Yeah, these are not flavors of ice cream that I enjoy.
Yeah, no thank you.
can I get the mushroom cheese flavored ice cream, please?
No thank you. Like, it doesn't even look good.
How about some gold flake? Is some gold flake involved? I feel like there should be some gold flake involved.
I'm watching a video of them. Oh, you can't see me. It doesn't look good. It looks like they put some, and then they drizzle some oil on top.
What about the fish that kills you, the puffer fish? They put some puffer fish in there?
Oh, yeah.
Puffer fish, mushrooms, and cheese. That sounds delightful.
I'm sending you the stupid video.
Don't send me the video. I don't want to watch it.
I'm sending it to you mostly because I'm mad that I watched it.
Puffer fish, truffles.
Wait, the part that made me the maddest was they didn't even eat it with an actual spoon.
Of course
they ate
not.
It with one of those little, like... You know when you're a kid and you go to school and you get the two, it's like the wood.
Well, I'm sure the wood is from an endangered species of a tree.
But they didn't know. Theirs was like some kind of plastic-coated, shiny metal. And they just do the wood. Do the wood.
But again, who's buying this? Nobody's buying this. It is.
You one. It should be at your house.
I wouldn't. I'm allergic to puffer fish. Just we as humans do the stupidest things. And again, congratulations. You made it into the Guinness Book of World Records by creating an Italian-Japanese fusion mushroom cheese ice cream. Good job.
You need the dumbest ice cream.
Yeah, that should be the record you hold for making the dumbest ice cream. Oh, you're charging $7,000 a scoop for it? Oh, now it's the world's most expensive ice cream. But you know what? Tony can beat your world record, because I could take a piece of plain old vanilla bean ice cream right now and put a price tag on it for $8,000. And if some yahoo's willing to spend $8,000 on a single scoop of vanilla ice cream, it doesn't matter, because the price tag says $8,000. I now own the most expensive ice cream in the world. And it's got one ingredient in it.
If I buy it from you for $8,000, you give me my $8,000 back. Like, we'll say I bought it, right?
Right.
Oh, perfect.
We own this guy. This record of stupid ice cream means nothing. We've got the world's most expensive vanilla ice cream. And you know why it's so daggone expensive? Because it was personally handcrafted and scooped by me.
Have we talked about the most expensivest with 2 Chainz?
You have mentioned it, that it's a show that you enjoy. I don't remember what it was. Oh, I was talking about something weed infused. Yeah, yeah. And you was like, yeah, that exists.
I watched the most expensivest. So stupid.
Well, there's our headline segment for this week, and I think we've covered most of the things that we want to cover. There's one thing that we always do, and that's we talk about our friends, and here's how that goes. Hey. Hey. I'm a shaky, shaky, shaky like you on my birthday. Oops, you're not invited. little segment we call Birthday Boost, and this is what we do every week. Every week we pick out four lucky listeners who get this thing called a Birthday Boost, where we say amazing, wonderful, incredible things that may or may not be true about you while wishing you a pleasurable future journeys around the sun. And for those not lucky enough to get a Birthday Boost, you will get an honorable mention because everybody that survives another day on this rock deserves a little acknowledgement. We don't do it in our Facebook post. We do it here. So if you ever see your name in the magic mirror, it could be you. As always, Chick Brew, you go first.
All right. Up first today, I've got Adam Dubose, who is actually my brother's best friend growing up. But I used to babysit him, and now he has a whole heap of kids of his own and plays baseball, doing great things. Looks like every time I see a post of him, it looks like he's having the best time being a dad. I can't believe little Adam is also a whole adult, just like my brother. They used to just be really annoying tiny humans. Now they seem to be really great guys. So happy birthday, Adam. Hope you're having the best birthday ever. Just get ready for the next one.
There are certain times when you really don't have a choice. When you really, that's not true. I have a choice. I can choose who to give this birthday boost to, or I could just let my mom celebrate her birthday. And old Mama Knuckles there, you know, she recently visited me here in Pennsylvania. We had a good time together. I enjoy my ma. And she's a wonderful lady, and she didn't abort me, so I really appreciate that. And she didn't kill me. She may have tried a couple of times, but she didn't actually kill me. She just made me stronger, because whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? I think about the life that we live. I know I couldn't have done any of it without her. And sometimes I sit in amazement of everything that she has done for the four stupid children that she had. She's a wonderful lady. I love my mother without a question. And I want to wish her nothing but the biggest, the brightest, and the best. And happy birthday, Ma.
Your mom is great.
She's pretty awesome. I like her.
She also listens to the show, so.
She does.
She's pretty great.
Yeah. Who's your next birthday boost?
My friend, Allie Rollison, stand-up comedian. It's my only tie to the comedy world other than you. But her and her wife just voluntarily forced to retire. I have no idea what their retirement situation was, but they are supposed to be retiring and heading over to Spain soon. So I am hoping to regain an old friend and a new neighbor. So happy birthday, Ali. Let's go ahead and hurry up and make that trek so we can hang out soon. That'd be great.
So in the next birthday boost, I've got a name that I'm pretty sure we have given a birthday boost for in the past, who has an upcoming project that we want to celebrate. So you're not getting a birthday boost this year until I get that interview and we can talk about your Kickstarter and I can help you push that program, Slade Ham. You're only getting an honorable mention. You're not getting a birthday boost this year. You probably got one last year. Just go back to this time last year and look at that episode. First of all, your name's Slade, okay? So if you ever see Slade in the magic mirror, we're most likely talking about you, because I'll be honest, I don't know any other Slades. You're the only Slade I know. So that is not a birthday boost, to be clear. That is just an honorable mention. The person, based on your story and Allie and how you guys are going to meet up after years and years and years, I'm gonna give Jason Hurl his birthday boost. I'm gonna tell you why, because he's a great guy. That's why. I remember Jason's email from many, many years ago, almost 25 years ago. I remember it was his name. It was spelled backwards. There was a number and there was a email provider attached to it. I remember his email, and I've reached out to him a couple of times throughout the years. Because he's a funny cat, man. He used to make me laugh. We used to work together, and I enjoyed him. So I reach out to him over the years, try to reach out to him. Never successful. And then one day, recently, probably within the last couple of months, it just turned out that Facebook worked its magic, and he showed up as someone you may know. And I was like, I definitely do know Jason Hurl. And And I immediately hit him up. I was like, it's been a long time. We should probably talk. And we haven't talked yet. It doesn't mean, you know, but I'm a man. He's a man. This is what men do. We say we need to talk, but we don't really talk. But one day we'll talk, and I want to catch up with him and see how his life's going. But right now, I'm taking this opportunity to give him a birthday boost because he's an amazing guy, and it looks like he's lived a daggone amazing life. Jason Hurl, happy birthday. And now, on to your honorable mentions.
Sean Cunningham, the king of balloon animals. Jessica Saddington, Noel, and Crystal Hatfield. She made me these really amazing prayer candles, but with my pets' faces on them. Love her for that. Thank you so much. Marcy Bond and Candice Bell.
All right, and my list, I got retired Mass Chief Jeff Sinclair, just recently retired. I got Bubbles. Bubbles is a super engineer, a hasher, Andreas Christensen, Mike Burton, very funny comedian out of New York, Tim Bulger, used to be the editor of the LaSalle Football League newspaper, Manny Cabal, Ken Hodell, one of two people I know who've been on The Price is Right, except Ken was there when it was Bob Barker, and Will C. was there when it was the new guy. What's the
Drew Carey?
Drew Carey, that's it. And of course,
Ramona Hass, who was on The Price is Right. She won a hot tub.
Oh, nice. And of course, Slade is on there. And unfortunately, man, I hate when the names pop up of people that are no longer with us. Rest in peace, my friend, my comedian, very funny guy, Wayne Felber, who's no longer with us. So that's all of our birthday wishes for the week. As always, you know, join the Facebook page and you'll fall into the things where we can find out when you have birthdays and we can give you your birthday boost. That's what that's all about. Happy birthday, everybody. We wish you nothing but the biggest, the brightest, and the best. Well, I've gotten to the point now where I have to go and hold my dog still while we put ear juice in his ears. Not eyeball juice in his eyeballs. That's what we got going for us. Please get your home setup figured out, because you don't understand how much time I spend in editing. I spend a lot of time in editing, and I send you these cool tools to make life easier. So please give it a shot.
Fair, I got it Friday, okay?
Uh-huh.
I need to get an extender. I haven't gone to get an extender.
I know. To be fair,
3 weeks. You tell me.
To be fair, you made a video that said you were going to go do it, to be fair.
And I did, but I can't get the computer to connect with a good signal.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this commercial that we have from Bidet King, thanks to Mr. Tamey. I can't wait to hear it with audio. I think that wraps it up for us this week. We've done all the things that we normally do. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening. As always, just be the best person that you can be. And if you were a great person today, be an even better person tomorrow.
And don't forget that you are loved.
Thank you for listening to T-Bone and Chick Brew. If you enjoyed that show, you should check out the Darrell McClain Show, independent media that won't reinforce tribalism. We have one planet and nobody's leaving, so let's reason together. You can find the Darrell McClain Show at the same place you actually listen to this show. Give it a shot.
Give it a shot.
I may have gotten ahead of myself there and wanting to see this bidet commercial, so if there's an interruption there, sorry about that. Love you, Lunsby.